Good morning everyone. So today we'll start with our next problem on variable separable form. 2x yy dash is equal to 1 plus y square at x is equal to 2, y is equal to 3. So first let's write this as dy by dx. 2xy into what is y dash? Dy by dx is equal to 1 plus y square. So now I'll bring this dx to the other side, which is in the denominator. So 2xy dy is equal to 1 plus y square into dx. Okay, so now we have to bring all the x terms together with dx and y terms with dy, right? So here I don't want 2x, or I don't want x. Here I don't want 1 plus y square. So divide the given equation by x into 1 plus y square, or multiply by 1 by x into 1 plus y square. So what do you have? 2xy divided by x into 1 plus y square into dy is equal to 1 plus y square into dx divided by x into 1 plus y square. So here 1 plus y square, 1 plus y square gets cancelled. Here x and x gets cancelled. You are remaining with 2y divided by 1 plus y square into dy is equal to 1 by x into dx. Right? So now our next step is to integrate on both sides. Right? So integrating on both sides, what do you have? Integral of 2y, 1 plus y square dy is equal to integral of 1 by x dx. So here if you observe clearly, you can see 1 plus y square, differentiation of this is nothing but 2y, that is in the numerator, right? So we have a formula, remember, integral of f dash of x divided by f of x dx is nothing but log of f of x. So log of the denominator. So we have log of 1 plus y square is equal to integral of 1 by x is nothing but log of x plus integration constant c. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm taking e to the power on both sides. So e to the power of log of 1 plus y square is equal to e to the power of log of x plus c. Okay, so you know one more formula. If this is in this form, you can write this as what is inside this log, right? Yesterday we came across one problem like this, right? So this is 1 plus y square is equal to here e to the power of log x plus c. Here we can split this, right? E to the power of mn, so e power m into e power n, we can write that way, right? So that is a power m plus n, a power m into a power n. Okay, so log of x into e to the power of c, right? So this becomes again 1 plus y square is equal to e to the power of log of x. That means inside this log we have x, we can write this as x into e power c is also a constant. Again, we can take that as a constant c itself. Okay, so we have 1 plus y square is equal to c into x, right, which is our general solution. How do you differentiate general solution? Yes, when we have a constant, we say it is a general solution. The constant here, if we replace it with a value here, a number, then this becomes a particular solution. Okay, now according to the second half of the question, we have x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 3. So we have to substitute x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 3 in our general solution. 1 plus y square is equal to cx. So y is equal to, what do we have the value? 3. And x is equal to, we have 2. Right? We are substituting that and finding the value of c and substitute back that c value here. Okay, let's start. So at x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 3, we are substituting x and y values here. So 1 plus what is y? 3 squared is equal to c into what is x value? 2. Okay. So now we have 3 squared is 9. 9 plus 1 is 10 is equal to 2c. So that is nothing but c is equal to 10 by 2, 2 1s are 2 5s are. So c is equal to 5, right? So substituting back c value in the general solution, what do you get? 1 plus y square is equal to c value is 5 into x. Okay, so this is a required solution. You can also write this as substituting c in equation 1 by taking equation 1 as this one. So you can mention this as equation 1, then you can show that c is substituted here. Okay. Our next question is x cube plus 2 into y is equal to x into x power 4, y power 4 plus 3 into y dash at x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 1. So what do we have? Okay, first we'll write this y dash as dy by dx. So after writing as dy by dx, we will bring this dx to this side. So we have x square plus 2 into y is equal to x into y power 4 plus 3 dx. I'll write here is into dy. Now I have to segregate with x and y terms. Here I don't want x, here I don't want y. So divide the equation by xy. So what do you have? X square plus 2y divided by xy dy is equal to x into y power 4 plus 3 divided by xy into this was dx. I'm sorry. Okay. So here y and y gets cancelled. Here x and x gets cancelled. So what do you have? X square plus 2 divided by x dx is equal to y power 4 plus 3 divided by y into dy. Right? So now integrating on both sides, what do you have? Integral of x square plus 2 by x dx is equal to integral of y power 4 plus 3 by y dy. Now I can split the numerator with the denominator, right? So what do I get? Integral of x square by x dx plus integral of 2 by x dx is equal to integral of y power 4 by y dy plus integral of 3 by y dy. So now 1x, 1x gets cancelled. So my integral becomes integral of 1 by x dx. Taking the constant 2 outside, I'll have 1 by x dx again is equal to 1y, and 1y gets cancelled. What do you have? Y cube dy plus integral of constant, I'll take it outside, so remaining is 1 by y dy, right? So now integrating this, what do I get? Integral of 1 by x is log x, right? Again 1 by x is log x. Again here y cube is y power 4 by 4, here 3 into your log y. Okay, here I'm sorry for the mistake. This was x cube. I wrote it as x square, right? So make it x cube here. This was x cube. So all this is x cube. So this was x cube. That means he will be remaining with. This is wrong. Obviously, x got cancelled. I should have had written in the numerator. This becomes x square, right? No confusions, right? Okay, integrating this, what do you get? This is x cube by 3 plus 2 log x is equal to y power 4 by 4 plus 3 into 1 by y is log y plus c, right? I'll bring all these things to this side. So we have x cube by 3 plus 2 log x minus y power 4 by 4 plus minus 3 log y is equal to c. This is our general solution, right? Don't write this short form, write fully. Okay, so now we have second half of the question. At x is equal to 1,
y is equal to 1. Substitute the value of x. What do you get? 1 cubed by 3 plus 2 log 1 minus 1 power 4 by 4 minus 3 into log 1 is equal to c. Find the value of c from this. You know log 1 is 0. Here also log 1 is 0. So we have 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4 is equal to c. So take the LCM. We get 12. 4. 3 4s are 12. So it is 4 minus 4 3s are 12. So it is 1 3s are 3. Is equal to c. 4 minus 3, 1 by 12 is equal to c. So now substituting the value of c in the general solution, what is the general solution? It was x cubed by 3 plus 2 log x minus y power 4 by 4 minus 3 log y is equal to, in the place of c, what should you write? 1 by 12. So this is our particular solution. Right? Our next question is, solve y into e to the power of 2x dx is equal to 4 plus e to the power of 2x dy. Okay, so here we can easily segregate this. Send this to this side and send this to this side. Right? That is e to the power of 2x dx. I am sending this term to this side. So I get 4 plus e to the power of 2x is equal to, I am sending this y to the other side. This becomes 1 by y dy. Now integrating on both sides, what do I have? Integral of e to the power of 2x divided by 4 plus e to the power of 2x dx is equal to 1 by y integral dy. Okay, so now if you observe, you can see the differentiation of this can be the numerator if I had a 1 by 2 here, right? So I'll multiply 1 by 2 on both sides. Okay, multiply 1 by 2 on both sides. What do you get? Integral of 1 by 2 into e to the power of 2x divided by 4 plus e to the power of 2x dx is equal to 1 by 2 into integral 1 by y dy. So this is of the form integral of f dash of x divided by f of x dx is equal to log of f of x. Right, so I can write this as log of the denominator 4 plus e to the power of 2x plus 1 by 2 into log y, right, plus our integration constant c. Okay, I'll bring this 2 to the other side. What do you have? 2 into log of 4 plus e to the power of 2x, this was equal to log of y plus c. According to the logarithmic formulas, we can write this as the power of this, right? Log m power n can be written as n log m, right? So this can be written as log of 4 plus e to the power of 2x, the whole square is equal to log y plus c. So here, if I take this as exponents, e to the power of, on both sides, log of 4 plus e to the power of 2x the whole square is equal to e to the power of log y plus c. Here you can split this as e to the power of log y into e to the power of c. This can be written as e to the power of log 4 plus e to the power of 2x the whole square. So now you know that you can write this as the things in the bracket here, right? 4 plus e to the power of 2x the whole square is equal to log y, and this e power c is again a constant, so I'll write it as a constant c. Sorry, this can be written as y, which is in the bracket. Okay, so what do you have? 4 plus e power 2x the whole square is equal to yc.
which is our required solution, and this is the general solution. We don't have any particular values given in the question, so we don't have to find the particular solution. Let's get into our next problem. My dx is equal to nx dy. So we were dealing with x and y as variables, right? So other things which you see, other alphabets, m, n, a, b, all those things will be considered as constants. Okay, since we are not used to such kind of problems, as soon as we see this problem we feel it is very complicated. Okay, this is very easy, so consider this m and n as constants. Okay, so we'll bring this y to the other side, x to this side. So we have m by x dx is equal to n by y dy. Now integrating on both sides, what do you get? This constant, I'll take it outside. Integral of 1 by x dx. Again here this constant, I'll take it outside. Integral of 1 by y dy. So what is integration of 1 by x? It is log x is equal to n into log y plus c. You know the formula, log m log n is, what is m log n? It's nothing but log n to the power of m, or n log m is m to the power of n, right? So this can be written that way. So log x to the power of m is equal to log y to the power of n, right, plus c. Okay, I'll write, I hope you can understand this, by power n it is. Okay, okay, so we have here, what I'm going to do is I'll take this as e to the power of, on both sides, e to the power of log x power m is equal to e to the power of log y power n plus c. Here again we can split this as log of y power n into e to the power of c. So here you all know log of what comes can be written, right? Again log of y power n. E power c is a constant again, so I can replace it with a constant c. So this is my solution, which is the general solution. Since we are not asked to find the particular solution, we can stop here. Okay. Our next question is x cos square y dx plus tan y dy is equal to 0. So here we don't want this y term, so divide the entire equation by y. So you have to write this again, cos square y dx plus tan y dy is equal to 0. So divide the given equation by cos square y. So what do you have? X cos square y dx divided by cos square y plus tan y divided by cos square y dy is equal to 0. Here cos square y gets cancelled. You have x dx plus tan y. What is 1 by cos square y? Or what is 1 by cos y? 1 by cos is secant, right? So 1 by cos is secant. So since this has square, this becomes tan y into secant square y. This remains the same. Now integrating on both sides. So when you integrate on both sides, what do you get? Integral of x dx plus integral of tan y into secant square y dy is equal to 0. So integral of this is x square by 2 plus, I will take here u is equal to tan y. So what is the differentiation of this with respect to y? Du by dy is secant square y. So we will see what is du. Du is nothing but secant square y into dy, right? Now substitute all these things here. So integral tan u, tan y can be written as u into sec square y dy, that is secant square y dy can be written as du is equal to 0. Now what is this integral? X square by 2 plus u square by 2 plus c is equal to
0, right? So you have x square by 2 plus, substitute back this u. What was u? Tan y. So we have tan y the whole square by 2 plus c is equal to 0. So we get x square, taking the LCM 2 here, x square tan square y plus 2c is equal to 0, which is our required differential equation, which is of general form since we have c, and they have not asked us to find the particular solution, so you can stop here. Okay, let us get into the last problem of this variable separable form. So we have x plus 2 dx is equal to x plus 3 sine y cos y dy. So x term is not required here. We'll bring this to the other side. This becomes x plus 2 divided by x plus 3 dx is equal to sine y cos y. Right, now integrating on both sides, what do you get? Integral of x plus 2 by x plus 3 dx is equal to integral of sine y cos y dy. Okay, so here what I'm going to do is I'm adding and subtracting 1 here, so that I'll get x plus 3 by x plus 3 minus 1. Okay, so x plus 2 plus 1 minus 1. So this I'm separating this way. Okay, I've clubbed this one here. Here we have sine y cos y dy. So now I'll add this up. What do I get? Okay, now I will split the denominator, x plus 3 by x plus 3 here, 1 minus 1 by x plus 3 dx, this minus is here, and the same thing I have written here, this cancels and becomes 1, here same thing I have written, this whole same thing, here sine y, I am taking it as u, so what is du with respect to y, du by dy is equal to cos y, so what is du, du is equal to cos y dy. Right, substitute this here. What do I get? Integral of 1 dx minus integral of 1 by x plus 3 dx is equal to sine y is taken as u, cos y dy is du. Now again you can't integrate this, so again take this x plus 3 as u, so u is equal to x plus 3. So what is du by dx is equal to 1 plus 0, right? Now du is nothing but dx. Substitute this here. You have 1 dx minus 1 by x plus 3 is u. Dx is du. Right? Dx is du. Is equal to integral of u du. What do you have? This is x minus log u is equal to u square by 2 plus c. Substitute back. So we have x minus log of, what was u? Don't get confused, okay? So this u was x plus 3, right? This integral we are taking is equal to, this u was sine y. The whole square divided by 2 plus c, so this can be written as x minus log of x plus 3 is equal to sine square y. Can be written as 1 by 2 plus c. So if I take the LCM, I can write this as 2x minus 2 log x plus 3 is equal to sine square y plus 2c, which is a required general solution. Since we are not given with any conditions to find the particular solution, we can stop here.
Thank you.